Mr. Chairman, Ambassador Ong Keng Yong, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I would like, first of all, on behalf of the Lao delegation, to have been invited to the second International OCEAN Conference 2017 held in the beautiful capital city of Colombo. I wish to take this opportunity to express my sincere gratitude to the Indian Foundation and the host country for their perfect logistic arrangement for this important conference. My perception regarding this topic becomes very relevant in the current situation nowadays. I share the views of many honorable speakers regarding the Indian Ocean, which is the third largest of the world ocean after the Pacific and Atlantic. It is bounded by Asia on the north, on the west of Africa, on the east of Australia, and on the south by the Southern Ocean, Antarctic. 50% of the world maritime oil trade are found in the Indian Ocean rim, and 40% of the world's offshore petroleum is produced in this, and one-third of the world's cargo movement and nearly half of its container traffic movement. It is well known that the Indian Ocean rim is comprised of the 32 countries, all of which have long-standing, historically significant cultural and economic ties with India. In order to help the Indian Ocean crowned with peace, progress, and prosperity, it is required to build the concerted effort to tackle the non-traditional security, such as transnational crime, information security, food security, piracy, investment, migration, human and illegal trafficking, poverty reduction, natural catastrophe, pandemic disease. They are now considered as core natural security issues. In the globalization era, the competition for energy has been prominent. Economic and population growth are drivers for emission and outpace the improvement of energy efficiency. The world in general is on the track of dangerous climate change. Regardless of this warning, the competition for natural resources has accentuated. Nations worldwide have to make major change in energy supply soon if they are to restrain climate change. As I have just mentioned just now, that the Indian Ocean is one of the biggest bodies of water, covering about one-fifth of the world's total area. In this regard, the Indian Ocean, like others, should be the area of free navigation and overflight, for it belongs to the common heritage of humankind. To have the Indian Ocean as the water of peace, progress, and prosperity, the concerted effort should be made not only among the stakeholders, but the outsiders should be part of it. The old concept of the Cold War is over. The cooperation in the 21st century needs more dialogue with multifaceted of approaches, since the economic growth has shifted to the Asia continent. In this connection, I think that the One Belt, One Road initiative issued by the People's Republic of China can also become the complementary factor to promote cooperation that can contribute to peace, progress, and prosperity development in the Indian Ocean. With its geographic location, Laos is the only one landlocked country in Southeast Asia with poor infrastructure, has put a constraint to the socio-economic development. In addition to that, the legacy of the war still remains threatening to the daily life of the peasants who are backbone of the country. Many peasants meet their destiny while working on their farmland saturated by bomblets, which become the obstacle to their routine works on the rice field. To get rid of this impediment, a landing strategy was introduced in parallel to regional and sub-regional infrastructure development trends. especially the frameworks of, among others, the ASEAN, Greater Mekong Sub-region, the Mekong-Konga Cooperation Frameworks, and Triangle Development Area, and other projects such as the North-South Economic Corridor linking China, Laos, Thailand is already implemented. Besides that, the East-West Economic Corridor linking Vietnam, Laos, Thailand, and Myanmar will help facilitate the economic interaction of this country to have access to the world markets via the Indian Ocean. Other mega project, the ambitious one, is on the way linking China, Laos, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore by high-speed railways will boost economic activities not only in the ASEAN region but also the world. There is no doubt that this project will get rid of the Indian Ocean as the main road to the destination. The strategy addresses the importance of infrastructure development, particularly the road transport sector, as the means to achieve to the 2020 vision for Laos to graduate from the list of least developed country and to eradicate poverty in the country, in order to contribute to the promotion of enhancing peace and stability in the region. Laos takes its foreign policy seriously as a tool to strengthen the diplomatic ties with countries in and outside the region and support the conflict solution by peaceful means, denouncing the use of force and military threat, supporting the five principles of peaceful coexistence. Due to the scarcity of natural resources in the globalization area, the competition for them has become prominent. The approach of seizure of the common heritage sites of the mankind becomes evident. From the past, there had not been any mechanism to touch upon the security in the Indian Ocean, crowned with accepted rules and agreements as guidelines for all countries in the region to interact for the sake of development, stability, and security in the Indian Ocean rim, aiming at facilitating the freedom of navigation, collective counter-terrorism efforts, and anti-piracy cooperation. Laos is fully committed to abide by the rules and regulations of the said institution for the sake of the sustainable development. I wish peace, progress, and prosperity to be prevailed in the Indian Ocean. Thank you.